big American gig, the first one you did was Denver?
Denver.
Can you tell me a bit about that?
It was a nightmare. Okay. We're on stage, the lights are down, it's like playing in Maple Leaf Gardens, right, whatever. There's anticipation in the crowd, and we're looking at each other. This is our first major show in the U.S. We just come off a heat wave, right? So we're revving, you know, like, okay, you know. The lights came on. All those cheers were like, who are these guys on stage? This is not Jeff Beck.
They were there for
Jeff Beck. The promoter did not put our name on the bill.
And some little promoter with a particularly nasal and unconvincing voice came out and asked them to give a very warm welcome to the king.
Oh, really?
They'd never heard of. And I think, you know, if I'd been in the audience, I probably would have had much the same reaction, which was that they pelted us with garbage for the entire set.
Well, I was lucky because Dave's a singer, so he's got to be on the mic, so he doesn't get to be a moving target. Sonny's on the keyboard, Max is on the drums. I was the only guy that got to move around and dodge all this stuff.
The other guys, they were standing on stage. At least they could dodge. They could move around their microphones and stuff like this.
Yeah.
I was right behind my kit, so how far could I go? Not very far.
There was probably 10 or 15,000 long-haired young guys with torn blue jeans yelling for Jeff. Jeff! Jeff! And we weren't really on the bill. I think we were added late or something. Or there was supposed to be some other opening band that they canceled.
Uh-huh.
And no mention of an opening band. So we happened to come out there in our leopard skin tights.
And so we walked out dressed up like these idiots and this, you know, jeans and T-shirt crowd for Jeff Beck, you know, was not expecting these, you know, the village people.
We only had to do a half an hour, not long.
Uh-huh.
But standing up there playing in front of 10 or 15,000 people giving you the finger.
Well, giving you the finger, why?
Well, it started off, everybody, you know, right away everybody's going, Jeff, Jeff, the lights go down low, Jeff, because we come walking out there.
And all of a sudden, all you heard was, boo, boo,
instantly everybody started booing us.
Oh, really?
Throwing bottles of water at us and running shoes.
Running
shoes bouncing off the stuff on the stage and you could hear coins bouncing off stuff. Ping.
They're throwing their money at you.
Whipping money, like not just pitching it, like throwing it.
Holy shit.
Oh yeah, it was amazing. And I think Max, I think he even got hit in the forehead or something with a quarter.
Three bars into the song, I'm playing along. All of a sudden I feel this, something on my head. I look down on my snare drum and there's blood dripping onto my snare drum. I'm thinking, what the heck's going on here? You know, this is, okay, it's a fluke, right?
What had happened? How come the blood?
The people were starting to throw stuff at the band. So they would have their little things, Coca-Cola or whatever soft drink in the little cups, crushed ice. They would just bunch them all up and just whip them at the stage.
I only had to stop once when a drink actually perfectly aimed landed right on my mic stand and exploded all over me.
Oh,
like that. Splat.
Afterwards, somebody came into the dressing room or whatever and they were like, somebody had thrown a shoe at us. I don't know if anybody got hit by it, but I mean, you got to think that they really got to hate you to throw a shoe because you're going to have to walk home with one shoe, right? So that always struck me as like a serious hate. Like, you're so pissed off at these guys that you're looking around, what can I throw? And it's like, all right, my shoe. I'm going to take this thing off. And I'm going to try to kill one of these guys with my shoe.
We stood our ground, and the people, and as there was just some people yelling and booing and that. But as we played our set and continued along, it spread like wildfire through the place.
The booing, you mean?
The booing and the harassing.
I remember, yeah, we were doing this one song called One Day Off, yeah. Okay?
I remember that doing my habit.
I remember looking out, singing, you know, playing Switch and the Glide. Looking out at the crowd, and there's like 10,000 people all in unison giving us the finger.
Oh, I remember looking out, and there was, you know, 15,000 people giving us the finger in unison.
You know? Oh, and so you got 17,000 people giving us the finger.
Like this. So you're just looking and you go, boy, these people, they really hate us.
Just an amazing. And we just stood there. Oh, my God. When we left the stage, the crew had to come and clean up all this. It was covered with shoes and bottles of water and, oh, anything you can imagine.
We go into the dressing room. And the first thing we get is, you guys are troopers. You guys are just unbelievable. And we are so apologetic for the people of Denver. Because people of Denver don't do this.
Oh,
this is so unusual for the people, because we're nice people, you know, like Rocky Mountain High and all this kind of stuff, you know, like we're sweet people. And we're going, sure you are.
The record company were so embarrassed when we came off stage, and we were kind of exuberant because, you know, we'd survived once again.
We made it through. We stood our ground and we played our set. Come hell or high water, we did it.